Hello, my name is Mike Wang, also known as the dude who fails to listen to anyone's requests here in the community. Whenever someone or whenever something needs fixing in a game, I just completely ignore it. In my past life, you know, I used to work on NBA Live, actually. I used to work for EA. I used to work on NBA Live, and I got fired because I was making love to the cover of NBA 2K9 on my lunch break. So, yeah. Huh? Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! What are you doing here? That bald head on KG, man, ain't nothing else like that in this world, man. Hello, my name is Scott O'Gallagher, you know, also known as the guy who cannot make a good game to save his life. In my past life, I used to hit the bar with my buddies, and then I started working for 2K, and everything started to go downhill since then, but still trying to remain optimistic and get a good game out for you guys, maybe next year. Come on, Scott, don't say things like that about yourself, man. We all agreed, we all think that your lackadaisical work here is amazing. Don't even say that. And my name is Robbie, also known as Two Bros Gaming, but my friends call me Karl Malone. I'm known for trying to get pictures from underage girls online that I shouldn't be messing with because I'm a grown man. And I actually don't work for 2K anymore. They fired me, but I still have a friend who works here, and so he's been letting me in on all the inside information and just telling me what the development process has been going like for NBA 2K22. So I'm here to share some secrets with you today. So for NBA 2K22, you know, we want to incorporate the elements that the community loved with NBA 2K21, and we want to import those features into NBA 2K22 so you guys can enjoy those gameplay elements and all that once again in the new game. So it only makes sense, right? So we're gonna take a look at some of the things that you guys have loved so far, and we're just gonna incorporate those into NBA 2K22 as well, such as the seasonal reward system, where you can reach level 40, and right now the reward is a Galaxy Opal Kawhi Leonard, and we want to keep a similar system, actually the same exact system with no changes whatsoever, in the new NBA 2K22 game, because we think this is actually a really good system for the people, for the no money spent players, for the people who love to grind, who love that intense grind. We want this system to be there for them. And in fact, when I say no changes whatsoever, I lied to you, because we actually are going to make it less rewarding. We think that's better in the long run. We're going to make it where you have to actually earn more XP, but it's going to be less rewarding. And the thing that we're really looking forward to doing is putting an end reward for level 40 that by the time this card is available, there'll be cards and packs that are way better than it, because we want people to open as many packs as possible. And that's all we care about. So we're going to put cards and packs that are better than the cards you have to grind for and spend hours upon hours, days upon days to go for. You know, we kind of did that with this Galaxy Opal Russell Westbrook. As you can see right here, I have zero rings because I don't play this game because it sucks and I made it myself. But if I were to get all the rings from each week, I would have gotten myself a Galaxy Opal Russell Westbrook. And I was actually on Twitter and I saw people complaining because they said Galaxy Opal Russell Westbrook needed an update and that the cards and packs were better. But you know what? I'm not going to listen to them because I don't care. Because to be honest with you guys, we here at 2K Studios have monopolized the virtual basketball scene, right? The industry. So we have no competitors. EA, what are they going to do? Make NBA Live? Pathetic. Huh. They don't make that game anymore. And even when they do, it does not compare to our game. And I wonder why, huh? So we're not going to change anything. We're just going to continue to make the game worse, and you guys are still going to buy it because we don't care. We're just money-hungry idiots, fools who just want to take your money and want you to buy packs. So we're going to deliberately put cards in a game that you have to grind for worse than the ones that you can get from the packs because we just don't care. Let's get Scott in here to talk about the new pack system that's going to be available in NBA 2K22. Hey guys, Scott back here. So we're going to talk about the pack system in NBA 2K22. I don't know why Mike Wang said new, because it's going to be exactly the same. Actually, it's not. I know exactly why he said new. The reason why he said new is because we're actually thinking about decreasing the pack odds here on NBA 2K22. We think the pack odds are too high. You know, we were forced to put the pack odds here on the game, but really we make it so it's kind of hidden, so you guys don't really know it's here. What you have to do, I'm not even going to say what you have to do. I'm just going to show you. But you can see the pack odds here because we were forced to put this in a game, or else it would have been considered too much gambling. So
You know, as you can see, you have a 4% chance of pulling a 92 plus rated player. We're actually thinking about decreasing this. And we wanted to make it below 1% chance of getting a 92 plus rated player in NBA 2K22. We think that's a fair percentage right there. We feel like people are pulling Galaxy Opals too much and the high rated cards and Pink Diamonds and whatnot. So we're just going to lower the odds. But we are also thinking about increasing the prices per pack too. And one thing that came up within us in one of the conferences we had here was making packs VC only forever and never allowing people to open packs with MT. You know, nowadays we do super packs with VC only, but we were thinking about doing all packs VC only because we honestly feel that that would improve the gameplay here and the My Team mode as a whole. So, you know, that's something we're trying to get worked out. Not sure if it's really going to come to fruition or not, but we hope it will. And I hope you guys really do enjoy that, by the way. So we're going to make packs VC, or we're going to try to make packs VC only, as well as we're going to try to decrease the pack odds. So honestly, I really think that's going to benefit this game. Hey guys, Robbie back here. So I'm going to leak some information that I was told by one of my inside friends here in 2K Studios. So one thing that they were actually planning on doing, not for NBA 2K22, well, this will carry over in NBA 2K22, but just to leak something for about NBA 2K21, we know last year in NBA 2K20, we gave you Spotlight Sims before I got fired. There were Spotlight Sims. Was it before I got fired? I don't know. But there were Spotlight Sims, and you can grind for Galaxy Opal Kobe Bryant, which was an intense grind. You know, we want to bring the Spotlight Sims. I don't know why I'm saying we, because I got fired. They want to bring the Spotlight Sims back. So that's exactly what they're going to do here in NBA 2K21 as well as NBA 2K22. So Spotlight Sims are coming back. The changes are as follows. It's going to be less rewarding as well as double the time investment. So what they're planning on doing, instead of giving you a Galaxy Opal like they did last year with a Galaxy Opal Kobe, they want to give a diamond player instead. And the diamond player, I'm not going to say who it is, I already know what the player is, but I'll tell you this, the diamond player has 5 Hall of Fame badges, has 10 gold, has 3 silver, and 2 bronze badges. Those bronze badges, man, yeah, great. Anyways, so yeah, it's going to be a diamond player, it's going to be double the time that it took to get Kobe. So I think it's going to be very rewarding. I mean, I know Kobe was a great card, but I think this diamond player, although it doesn't have the most badges and it's double the time for the Kobe grind, I think once you see the name for the card, I think you guys will love it. I mean, I don't know, man. That's just how I feel about it, to be honest with you. I think this grind is going to be well worth it. But it's up to you guys if you want to grind this stuff or not, you know? Yo, Carmelone, man, you're saying way too much. You got to chill out. Just chill out on that, man. Overall, guys, those are the main features that are going to be available in NBA 2K22. Just to sum it up, things are going to be kind of exactly the same as they are right now. In fact, the menu is going to look exactly the same as it is right here in NBA 2K21. And, you know, one thing that we're excited for in the new game is to be able to make the game strictly for next gen. So, you know, with NBA 2K21, we had to develop the game not only for last gen, but also for next gen, which I feel like it limited our capabilities here. But now, because next gen would have been out for a full year at the time of release for NBA 2K22, I'm very excited to see what we can do with the capabilities of the next gen consoles. Hope you guys did enjoy this little teaser, and we'll see you opening packs on NBA 2K22.